Here I'm asked to solve a linear inequality. Now, the only thing different about these is that whenever you divide or multiply by a negative number, you reverse the inequality. So first step is to add 2 to both sides. That leaves me with 3x is less than or equal to 9. Okay, so here I'm going to be dividing by a positive number, so I'm not going to reverse the inequality. X is less than or equal to 3. So any number less than or equal to 3 should solve the original inequality. Now there's infinitely many solutions here, so one way to express your answers is to actually shade them in on a number line. Notation's different in different books, but here I'm going to use a solid dot at 3, and I'm going to shade in all the numbers less than 3. This is the solution set represented graphically. Okay, negative 2 should solve the original inequality, and check it out. 3 times negative 2 is negative 6, minus 2 is negative 8. Negative 8 is less than 7. Actually, any number in that interval. Sometimes they're going to ask you for interval notation. Interval notation for this example looks like this, from minus infinity all the way up to 3 with a square bracket. That means that indicates that it's inclusive. 3 is included in the solution set.